hoping Guile Urien, even though that's a bad matchup for Urien.
That's
so
interesting.
They say.
Yeah,
so
in this version, who knows, right? Like, we haven't seen that much of this season. And traditionally, I think a lot of Urien players don't love the matchup, but they can do it, right?
Yeah,
like,
it definitely can be done. He has the tools. He has definitely has the tools to fight the match.
It's not like he doesn't have a great comeback factor. Nope. If he doesn't have good anti-fireball stuff, like, the character can do it. Especially in this version where, you know, Urien is about the same as he's ever been, mm-hmm. and Guile's a little worse for wear. So we'll see kind of what the character selection's like. Knuckle Dude has some interesting characters to think about here, too, because, you know, now, obviously, Nemo plays a little bit of Colleen as well.
Yep.
I mean, of his characters, maybe the best matchup now is Mika. Mika is pretty good against Urien. I think a lot of Mika players are fine with that matchup against this character, so I'm not sure who he'll play.
Yeah, I could see that. I could see him going Mika.
Yeah. Worked out against Didymo Koff, but against Nemo, I feel like against Nemo, I would hate to have a command throw. Just because he's so, like, you never know what the guy's going to do. So trying to command throw him is scary.
And he's actually, he's very scary with that EX headbutt. That's once he gets that meter, it's very scary.
I don't know. That's what it's like against this guy. So who is he going to pick? I feel like usually he used to go Guile.
Oh, wow. You agree with this? Do you? This is President of the World versus...
I've seen him play this character before. He used to pick it against Minot last
week. He's got some cheap stuff with this
he
character.
He is a very good
very,
character.
He's very solid with this character.
What's exciting about that is, you know, after this set of pools, so right after this is over, right, mm-hmm. we're going to get into the C pool.
Okay.
C1 and C2. And in C2, we have 801 Strider.
Wow.
Who's
going
to
show us some
in
G?
In the U.S. Yeah.
Really? Okay.
So I can't wait to see that, but we got some G here. A character that's good at making Urien guess and can kind of put him on the back foot, which is where he doesn't want to be, especially a guy like Nemo.
Okay. So don't forget, one of G's weaknesses is no wake-up options.
Yes.
All right? So we'll see how this plays a factor in this matchup.
That's a punish.
Yep.
Yeah, on the
power.
That
was actually very nice. Great block. Ooh, he's tasting those boots. With Steve Maddens.
The back throw. Yep. And you see Knuckle Dude, he's just going to wait, try to get the level ups so that he can kind of throw those big, powerful fireballs.
Nice. Nice three-piece. Going to work right now. Atom Bomb.
Nice check on the dash up after the throw. Take the level. He's got the powered up fireballs. Now big jump. EX to the corner.
G covers a lot of range with those jump-ins. Oh, no. No one home.
Yeah.
No one home. Not sure who he was trying to call.
I'm not sure either. He safe jumped, actually, what Nemo was trying there. Cross up low.
Great defense from Knuckle Dude.
Trying to anti-air the knee drop, but V-trigger available. Got to watch low smash and activate from G.
Unable to jump over right there.
Oh. The throw to get the kill. That's Nemo. It. This is the thing about him. Is like, you know, he's like, all right, I'm backing up. And if you're Knuckle Dude, you're like, all right, I got to find a try to, you know, activate. I got to look for something. And then Nemo just comes after you, even though he had the life lead. That's hard to expect. You're just like, what? Excuse me?
Expect the unexpected. Nice. Nice trade. Okay.
No answer.
Jumps in with the fierce. And just like that, he is backed up into a corner with no backup, no help.
Oh, punish. Charge roundhouse. Double charge roundhouse. There's that light kick into the buffer. Walk up. Takes the pressure. Goes for the low smash into the activate.
There we go.
Nice. Yeah.
Okay.
And back, even after that back dash, he could go for the command throw. He doesn't, though. The crouching light kick, wake up, critical art. Big damage. Nemo, he's seen the tapes. He's like, oh, you guys like to wake up critical art in the U.S., huh? No problem. The mirror doesn't punish. Goes low. No counter hit. The overhead, the wheel kick.
Oh! He went right through the Aegis Reflector.
Instant
stop!
Overhead. Not enough to kill. The reversal headbutt. Nemo with game one.
That was still a beautiful display from Knuckle Dude. I really liked what was going on there in that corner. But you know what? Nemo able to clutch it out with that headbutt.
No fear in his heart.
None at all. This man is sharing thoughts. He's the mind reader.
That's the way he plays. Yep. There's never any shred of doubt in his own choice. Nemo's just like, I'm right. Whatever.
Whichever way it goes, it doesn't matter. Win or lose, he accepts it. I like that.
Yeah, he lives and dies by his own choices.
Yep.
Like, if he wakes up 100 times in a row with the X headbutt and he loses, he's like, you know what? I'm right. It's like that.
All right, so here we go. Wow, he comes back with G.
Yeah, locked and loaded. Interesting, too. I mean, Nemo used to play this character G as well, and he kind of was like, I don't think he's that good, so I'm not going to play with him anymore. And now you see, you know, this is what Knuckle Dude's trying up against him. It's an interesting choice. It hasn't you know, it didn't work out in the first game, but I think there was a lot of good ideas there that he can probably stick to, right? It doesn't look like he's uncomfortable with the matchup. It just looks like, you know, Nemo got the better of him in game one.
Yeah. Here we go, backbreaker.
Check on the dash. Doesn't take the level. He wants the pressure, which most G players do outside of the corner. What in the fierce?
Yeah. Literally.
Just out of out of the air?
Okay. Knuckle Doo trying to maintain that space, putting out the right normals.
Yeah, and he had a really well-spaced wheel kick, too.
Yep.
He EX over the fireball, though Nemo didn't dash up or anything.
Nope.
That
very unfortunate. That's a waste of resource, but not this time. Definitely went to good use.
Yeah, and G has that really great safe jump, especially against a character like Urien, slow reversal. Oh, walk back throw. Yeah, he's seen the setup before.
Wow, the back dash right into the reflector.
Overhead. Didn't even hit the button to try to challenge the mirror. Activates. Throws out the V-skill.
Oh,
what are you doing? And the punish. He threw it right into the mirror.
And this is usually when Knuckle Doo turns it on.
That thanks to Hi-Fi. He saw that crouching fierce activate, and he knew walk back throw.
He hightailed it out of there. Yep.
Yeah. He saw it hit Tokido. He's like, no thanks.
At all. No thank you at all. Okay.
Jump in. Not quite in time.
Not at all. That's actually very surprising. I thought he would have got that. Knees.
That
four
wake up jab
to
again.
The wall.
EX. 50-50 here. Backdash. He can still command throw there. That's why Nemo tried to get out of there. Wrong charge, but it didn't matter. EX.
Still got it. Oh, no. Another drop from Knuckle.
Yeah, and he tried to anti-air the knee drop again and lost.
Good patience. Oh, no. I'll take you. Have to take the grab. Nice.
V reversal. He doesn't want to deal with that EX into the mirror or anything like that. Another one. V reversal again.
Very
tons
smart.
Of gray life, but you got to watch demos like EX knees or
EX anything. Oh, very unfortunate.
There's a ton of gray life up there. Punish.
He's in.
Instant overhead to low. Wow, wake up down tap.
Oh.
The back throw.
It.
Not enough to kill. Goes low. One hit will do it. Charges up fireball. Wow,
Knuckle Doo is on it. He's ready.
The V reversal again. Walking him down, he
that
dashes.
Was so gutsy. So gutsy play.
You know Nemo has EX tack 4Ds!
Oh, double KO!
Nemo moves on in winner's bracket with the double KO over Knuckle Doo's G.
Man, and what a wild match. I know Doo is saying to himself, what if I played Guile? Right?
what if
I played Guile?
Or what if in those moments I was just a little closer, a little faster, the double KO? What if you were like this close?